When God is rubbing you against the rock, it doesn't mean that He is destroying you. It means that He is polishing you to shine more, more and more. And this is the situation in which God is still with us. He has given this opportunity to us. I am there, you are there, we are connected. How? Digitally. You and me, we both are working hard at home. I know people that you are working very hard at home. So we have to keep this spirit going. We have to be positive. We have to be safe at the same time. And we have to be happy at the same time. So with this thought, we'll start our session of commercial studies. Let's go. So class 10th, this is your new edition commercial studies books by C.B. Gupta, Goyal Brother Precautions. And in this, we will be continuing with our chapter number 4, that is our consumer protection. Correct? Now, firstly, we are going to discuss the meaning of consumer protection. But before that, you should know who is a consumer. So who is a consumer? Consumer is the person. Is the person who consumes the goods and services. Correct? I know you know it already, but let's recall. Who is a consumer? Consumer is the person who consumes the goods and services. Correct? Now, what is consumer protection? Consumer protection means protecting the consumer. Protecting the consumer from what? From unfair trade practices. So, it is a practice of protecting buyers of goods and services and the public against unfair trade practices in the market. Correct? Certain cheatings are done. So, we have to protect our consumers. And for that, we have Consumer Protection Act 1986. Right? Next is meaning of consumer exploitation. It means harming the interest of consumer in various ways, like overcharging, charging unjustified higher prices. All right? Second, underweighing, giving less weight or quantity. Third, adulteration means mixing unwanted elements in goods. Fourth, false advertisements, like example, use a particular cream and you will become fair within a week, or use certain belts and you will be slimmer. Correct? So these are all the types of consumer exploitations for which Consumer Protection Act is being provided to us. Next, we come to importance of consumer awareness. Now, what is importance of consumer awareness? Before that, what is consumer awareness? It means education. A consumer has to be rational. Rational means he should know goods and bads about himself. What is good for himself and what is bad for himself. So he should be aware about that. Correct. As a consumer, it is very important to be aware. It is very important that you should be aware whatsoever thing you are purchasing. You're going to the market, you're going to purchase something. You have to be very careful and you have to be very aware of that. You bring shampoos. Nowadays, what is going on in the market? That you should use sulfate free, you should use paraben free shampoos. Correct? So you have to see what? At the back of that bottle, in the description box. In the description box, what do you have to see? You have to see the specifications about that. You have to see that, does it contain paraben? You have to see that, does it contain sulfate? Does it contain alcohol? Does it contain contents that can actually damage and harm your hair, etc., etc.? Correct? So you have to be very rational about yourself. You have to be aware. And how you can be aware? You can be aware by educating yourself. Go. We have to be aware and careful. Consumers can oppose attempt made to exploit them. Means that if we are aware, if we are careful about ourselves, nobody can exploit us. But if we are not aware, if we are not careful about ourselves, if we are not rational, any strategy is very simple to exploit us. There are many consumer awareness campaigns like Jago Grahak Jago. You must have heard this. You must have seen advertisements on these. Like it says what? It says that Jago Grahak Jago means you have to be aware. You have to be aware of your rights. You have to be aware of the product that you're consuming. You have to be aware of all those things for which you are paying. Example. Recognize it? What is it? Mountain Dew. It says that it contains caffeine. You know, caffeine is not good for health. We know it. Don't take it, otherwise it is an old bottle. Okay, it contains caffeine. It is not good for our health. Doctors, everyone, they don't recommend caffeine, especially for 18 below. But taste, we take it, we consume it, though it is written in bold letters, but still we don't consider it. We are not aware of it. We pay 40 rupees for it. Correct. And in summers, so we pay 45 rupees. 5 rupees for what? Electricity charges. Why? Because it is chilled. Alright. So you have to be aware. Jago, Grahak, Jago. Next, methods of consumer protection. Now there are few methods. There are few methods that the government has given. What are those? Business self-regulation means to correct oneself first. You have to correct yourself first. Before correcting anybody else, you have to first correct yourself. This is second. Consumer self-help. Help yourself means consumers should educate themselves. As I told you, you should be aware of the rights. You should be aware of your rights. You should educate yourself first. Correct? Third, we come to consumers associations. Means there are few organizations, there are few associations are there which actually does what? They actually teach about consumers' right. They will teach you that how you can go in the market and be rational and be aware of yourself so that nobody can fool you. Nobody can cheat you. All right. And the last point is, fourth point is, government regulations. What is that? Government can form strict laws, rules and regulations for our protection. So with this, we finish with our last topic, which is method of consumer protection. Till then, I want you to go through these notes of mine plus your chapter. It has also provided you certain elaborated notes. Please go through that and I'll see you in the next session. Till then, stay safe, take care. Bye-bye.